Introduction to Geometry, Level 6. In this video, we're going to use the following figure to find the union and intersection of various lines, line segments, and rays. Recall that the symbol for denoting the union of two sets is this U-shaped symbol. It is essentially a U for union. The symbol for the intersection of two sets is an upside-down U. It is important to understand that when we are dealing with lines, line segments, and rays, a set will consist of all the points that a particular line, line segment, or ray is composed of. For example, you can think of a line as a set of all points that extend infinitely in both directions. A line segment is a set of all points that starts at one point and ends at another point. And a ray is a set of all points that starts at one point and extends infinitely in one direction. With that said, let's go ahead and start with the first example. Use the following figure to find the following unions and intersections. In this first problem, they are asking us to find the intersection of line segment AD and DC. If we think of line segment AD as a set of all points that forms this line, we would obtain the following points. In the same manner, the set of all points that form line segment DC will consist of the following points. Since we're trying to find the intersection of these two set of points, we see that both lines contain one point in common. In this case, point D. So the intersection of line segment AD and DC is a set containing only point D. Now let's try the second example. In this problem, they're asking us to find the union of ray EC and ray EA. Notice that the diagram does not contain any arrows. Nevertheless, we can either imagine or add the arrows in the diagram when needed. For this example, we are referring to ray EC, which is a set of all points located here, even the points that extend infinitely in this direction. In the same manner, the set of all points of ray EA are located here. Again, even the points that extend infinitely in this direction. Since we are asked to find the union of these two set of points, we essentially want to unite or merge all the points from both rays, forming a new set. This new set will form a line segment, which can be denoted as line segment AC or line segment CA. We can also argue that the union of these two rays also forms an angle. In this case, we form a straight angle, specifically angle AEC or angle CEA, with the vertex located at point E. Straight angles will be discussed more fully in a later video. For now, either the line segment or angles are acceptable answers for this problem. Alright, let's go ahead and try the next example. Here we are asked to find the intersection of line AC and line BD. The set of all points forming line AC are represented as follows. And that of line BD are represented as follows. Since we're looking for the intersection of these two lines, we see that they have point E in common. So the intersection of these two lines is a set that contains point E. Alright, let's move along to the next example. Here we need to find the intersection of line segment BC and line segment AD. The set of all points that are associated with line segment BC are represented as follows. And those associated with line segment AD are represented as follows. Notice that none of the points of either line segment BC or line segment AD intersect. This means that there are no points that both line segments have in common. This results in an empty set, which is represented by the following symbol. Okay, let's try the next example. Here we need to find the intersection of ray AC and ray EC. Here we have to be careful, since the way we denote rays is going to be key in this problem. The first letter on a ray represents the endpoint, and the second point is in the direction in which the ray infinitely extends towards. The set of all points of ray AC is represented as follows. And the set of points of ray EC is represented as follows. For this problem, we're looking for the intersection of these two rays. This occurs in the following region. Notice that it forms a ray with endpoint located at point E and extends infinitely towards point C. So the intersection of these two set of points is a set of all points that forms ray EC. Alright, let's proceed to the next example. Here we need to find the union of ray DA and ray DC. The set of all points represented by ray DA consists of the following points. And a set of all points represented by ray DC consists of the following points. Since we are looking for the union of these two rays, we see that we essentially form angle ADC or angle CDA, with vertex located at point D. Remember, when we are asked to find the union of two sets, we want to merge all the elements together. In this case, all the points that are located on ray DA or ray DC or in both. Alright, let's end the video with the final example. Here, we need to find the union of line segment EC, line segment CD, and line segment DE. Notice that we have three distinct sets. The concepts and ideas are the same, regardless of the number of sets. So don't panic if you get a problem that contains multiple sets. Alright, the set of all points represented by line segment EC consists of the following points. The set of all points for line segment CD are represented as follows. And a set of points of line segment DE consists of the following points. Since we're trying to find the union of all these points, we see that by merging all these points together, we create a new set. We create a new set of points that represents a triangle. Specifically, triangle ECD, or written in other ways as triangle CDE, or triangle DEC, or triangle DCE, or triangle CED, or triangle EDC. As long as you label the points forming the line segments or sides of the triangle clockwise or counterclockwise. Alright, in our next and final video on this section, we're going to go over more challenging problems that ask us to name and find the union and intersection of geometric figures.